Hello, my name is Dr. Ava. How are you?
Good.
Good. Are you ready for your surgery?
Yeah,
nervous. Don't be nervous. Do a million of these a day. I promise. Yes. Okay, so there's just a few housekeeping things we have to kind of get out of the way. The first being, I'm just going to ask you a bunch of questions, okay? And then we'll physically prep you for the procedure, okay?
Yeah.
All right. Sounds good. So it's going to be kind of tedious. I said some questions, some minutiae, just to make sure that you're physically ready for the surgery. I know we've done a lot of this in the preliminary pre-op appointments, but we just need to make sure that now going under the anesthesia, you are ready. Nothing to be scared of, just super routine, but it is something fairly serious that we have to take seriously. So, you ready? Okay, awesome. We obviously know your name, birth date. Has any of that changed? Okay. Well, obviously your birth date didn't change. Your name can change though. Yes. Okay. Is the address still the same? All right. Contact info, email, phone number. Okay. And your emergency contact is? Okay. See, that is different. Can you spell that for me? Mm-hmm. That's an I or E. Okay. Didn't really hear you. Okay. And who is that to you? Okay. And their phone number. And are they here with you today? Okay, awesome. All right. Okay. Have the medications you're on changed? Okay, dosages changed, anything like that? That's very, very important. Verifying allergies. Okay. Any issues with breathing or coughing, colds, anything upper respiratory in the last 3 to 5 days? Okay. Any fever? Okay. Any unexplained edema, swelling? Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there anything you feel we should know before going into the procedure? Any last minute changes? Anything? Okay. All right. And who is your primary doctor? Okay. Any questions for me? Okay, let's begin. So, first things first, I'm going to take a look at the area and I'm going to shave it. Okay, that's step one. So, if you could just give me your arm here. I'm gonna shave it and then I'll give it a few minutes just to make sure there's not any crazy irritation. I'll take some of your vitals, do that, and then I'll come back. I will prep the area, alcohol prep it, sanitize it, and then I'll mark up some of the incision points we're gonna be working with. Okay. All right. I'm gonna spray the, we don't use shaving cream, we just like a shaving. It's kind of between a liquid and a gel. Just makes it a bit easier. So, gloved up here. Okay. All I'm gonna spray this very, very gently in here. I'm just gonna be cold spray. Good. Yeah, it's just so we don't have to also add water. It's just like this very thin kind of cream. Cream gel, shaving cream, technically. Add a little more of that shave gel so to make sure there's no reaction on the skin for the procedure, which makes everything a little bit difficult. Look, it's pretty good. Just wipe it off here. Okay, some water. Okay. I'm just gonna let that kind of do its thing for a few minutes while I take kind of all the vital tests. Alright. First things first. I'm gonna listen to your heart. Just breathe normally. Okay. Good. Again, breathe normally. Okay. Can't breathe normally. Okay. Check it back. Okay, now I want you to take a deep breath in. Through the nose, out through the mouth. Good, one more. Good. Okay, do the same thing, but now hold it for about 3 seconds if you can, as long as you can. All those up front here. Breathe in, breathe out, and then we'll do one holding. Okay. Breathe in. Out. Good job. Breathe in again, hold. Good job, same thing. Now hold. Be good there. Right, let's take your blood pressure. Slide it on again. So, Okay, perfect. Finger check. I was looking around for it. Just stick your finger right in there. Thank you. Check your hearing really quickly. I just want you to tell me, close your eyes, I want you to tell me what side you hear the tuning fork on. So this is what it sounds like. Okay. I want you to close your eyes, I want you to tell me which ear you hear it out of. Okay? Awesome. Okay. Your eyes a little bit. Eyes, nose, mouth. So first just look right at my nose, my glasses, my red lips, whatever you want. Just pick something and try to look forward. Right in my nose. Good. Okay. Again, keep looking straight. Yeah, we're just making sure that there's no issue with any trauma to the eyes or any trauma to the any parts of the brain, any sign of stroke or anything like that that would cause any issues for us today. Issues in general. So just making sure that everything is functioning the way that it should be. I'm gonna get up close and touch your eyes. Is that okay? Not your eyeballs, but your eyes. Okay. Swelling, anything that could indicate any issues, any singular side swelling would be not ideal. So we're just making sure all of that is good. Okay, I'm just gonna lift up your nose just like this, just check inside your nostrils. Perfect. I want you to open your mouth, stick out your tongue, say ah. Awesome, thank you. Again, ah. Good. Alright, well that seems to be functioning properly. Do you have any questions about anything I just did? Okay, awesome. Alright, so I'm going to come over and take a look at that arm. If you could just... So no reaction during the press test, no reaction to the shaved jaw. It's very benign, it's for very sensitive skin. The problem is we don't want the skin to warp or swell in any way. that's going to affect where we make our incisions and how everything, once we're done, is going to lay. We want to make sure everything is essentially the way it's going to be when we're done with the procedure, so that way everything is placed properly, stitched correctly. We don't account for things being shifted or swollen or anything if we don't expect it to be. So that's the situation there. Let me sterilize the area. Okay. Give me your arm if you could. Thank you. We sterilize it again once we get in there. And it doesn't remove any of the Sharpie that I'm going to apply. But this is the big sterilizer. And then we'll sterilize it one more time just as we get in there to make sure that nothing has contaminated it, since the marker is not sterile, but we do use a fresh one on every patient. Day is probably too many, but I do 6 or 8 depending on the day. Yeah. Easy peasy. It's easy peasy, I promise. Nothing to be worried. Take the Sharpie here, and I'm just going to kind of mark up the areas that we're going to be working on. If this makes you uncomfortable, this is going to be the actual kind of incision lines to watch. Please don't. They're all necessary and purposeful, I promise. They're guidelines, measurements, markings for where the veins are typically located, just to kind of map it out a little, as well as incision lines. Like I said, this freaks some people out, so that's why I gave you the heads up. Believe it or not, when we're done, we actually sign it. So that way the other doctors know that it was done correctly, and who did it. So that way there are no mistakes and mess-ups. Alright. Are you ready to go? Do you have any questions, concerns, comments, last minute, anything for me? Okay. Sounds good. Oh, if you are ready, I'm gonna put the mask on you. Ready? All right, so I'm gonna put this on you and we're gonna count down from 20. Does that sound good? All right. Bridge good, and you're just gonna breathe in and through your nose, out through your mouth, okay? Awesome. Ready? 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,